All of our families went through so much that day. We so miss them, and we will never forget them. And I can't thank each of you enough for being here to honor their memory and their contribution.
Today, one of the darkest days in space history is remembered. Family members and NASA pay tribute to the ill-fated Space Shuttle Columbia crew. Good afternoon, I'm Gail Pascal Brown. A somber day for NASA. We remember the astronauts who died on board the Shuttle Columbia 5 years ago. On this day in 2003, seven astronauts lost their lives when the shuttle disintegrated above Texas during reentry. This morning at the Kennedy Space Center, family members, NASA workers, and fellow astronauts turned out to remember those who lost their lives. Astronaut Eileen Collins is the commander who flew the return to flight mission, the first mission after the disaster. She talked about how NASA has worked hard since then to improve safety procedures.
But I am humbled. And I know that whatever I say can't possibly describe the experience of 5 years ago and the difficult effort of returning the space shuttle to flight. But our purpose today is also to learn and to remember.
An investigation revealed the fatal damage was caused a little more than a minute after liftoffs. Insulating foam from the external fuel tank struck and damaged the left wing. NASA has learned many lessons since the Columbia disaster. Astronauts now inspect the shuttle in space to see if there is any damage from the launch. Astronauts have also been trained on how to fix damage to heat shields while in space. Plus, there are more cameras to examine the shuttle and fuel tanks during launch to watch for insulation coming off the fuel tanks. Also, engineers have changed the design of the fuel tanks and of the insulation on fuel tanks to reduce the change of insulation coming off. Meanwhile, NASA is keeping a close eye on its latest mission to space. The Shuttle Atlantis is expected to launch next week. On Wednesday, NASA said it found a bent radiator hose in the shuttle's payload bay. The hose is apparently working, but NASA is worried it may break during takeoff. NASA will meet again tomorrow to reassess the situation. The shuttle is scheduled to lift off on February 7th.